Today I'm going to teach you how to create VS Code snippet, how to make tab control inside them, and how to place some placeholder text in your snippets. First of all, let's see how or where you would put those snippets. So if you're on a Mac, do Shift Command P and to pull up this bar, or and if you're on Windows, press just Shift Control instead of Command P, and then type in configure user snippets, should pop up. If you press this, then you can in VS Code you can create language specific snippets, like snippets in JavaScript or in other languages, C++, etc. Or you can create global snippets like this. If you want to create global one, click here, but we will create JavaScript ones. And for that, I'm going to go inside here. And this will open, this should not be here. This should open this file, JavaScript, it's a JSON file, in with some comment in here. We want to delete this comment, and here we're going to specify our code snippets. So for this, I'm going to go inside here, in this article from VS Code that explains code snippets, link down below. And here I have the format of how you would specify a code snippet inside this file, inside this JSON file. So this is basically JSON. So first of all, you specify the name, then the prefix of your snippet or the shortcut, then the body, the actual snippet, and a description. And there's an easier way to create this using this app. Because we don't want to mess around with creating this exact format. So the example I'm going to use in this video is this code. I'm going to create a code snippet from this Express server. So to create a code snippet, just copy the code you want to make a snippet from. Go inside the browser, open this app, link down below. And paste your code in here, where it says your snippet. Then give it the description of Express server, because we're creating an Express server. And then for our shortcut, it's going to be just ES. And also now, if I just copy my snippet and go inside Visual Studio Code, go inside my JavaScript.json, where all of the snippets should be, and just paste this in here, save, and go inside my app, and then just say ES. You see that my snippet was being created because I added it into my snippets file called javascript.json, and it says ES. And if I now press enter or tab, I'm going to get my code printed out. Also, another thing I will show is tab control. So you can control where your if you click tab once your snippet runs, where your cursor will go. So if you, for example, in this case, you might want to change the port on your Express server, and if you, when you press enter, when you do ES, press enter, your cursor can go right. You can make it go right here, so you can change your port to something like 5000. And you can do that just by saying $1. And if you want, again, when you press tab for the second time, your cursor to go, let's just say here, because you may want to change the URL. And then to add another sign, you will just say $2, because this is your second placeholder. And now we're going to copy this snippet here, and we're going to go inside our snippets and replace this with the new snippet. Click save, and then when I go inside here, delete this, and try to do my snippet, press enter. See, the cursor went exactly on this port. And now I can say 5000 instead of the the placeholder of 3000. And now watch, if I press tab again, my cursor will go when I set it, it should go on this place, in the second placeholder that we've specified with dollar sign 2. And now I can say something like index.html instead of the usual Discord. Also, now I'm going to teach you about the third thing, which is setting up some placeholder text. So most of the time, let's just say you're using the port 3000, but you want to your cursor, your tab control, to go on this port just in case you want to change it. So to make 3000 your placeholder text, you just type in again your dollar sign and then these curly brackets, then say 1 because this is your first placeholder, and then say these things, and then just say your placeholder text. In our case, it's 3000. So now, what this will do, this syntax, it will make our cursor to go here on this 3000, but 3000 will be a placeholder text. You can also do the same here if you just do these curly brackets, and again, say, let's just say our placeholder text is this slash. Now, if I copy this snippet, you'll see what will happen. If I go inside Xcode and replace my snippet, save it, and if I now try to pull out my snippet again, press enter, I will have my cursor here right on 3000. So I have my placeholder 3000 text, but I can change it to something like 5000, very easy. If I now click tab, my cursor will go exactly on this get where you can put this URL and say something like index.html, of course with a slash like this.